Act 1. Life expectancy. Sorry. The gate looked far too pompous for what it was. In fact, the gates in general seem to do that, but this one especially so. Red bricks, black iron, and grey plaster, assembled into a hole that didn't feel welcoming at all. I wonder if it looked like what a gate for school should look like, but I couldn't really decide. Probably no. Of course, I didn't want to get stuck on thinking about the gate for too long, so I entered through it with a brisk pace that felt surprisingly good. Moving forward feels good. So I walked towards the main building of Yamaku Academy with this brisk pace. I'm alone, as my parents are taking my stuff to the dorms. There's supposed to be someone waiting for me. Grounds are especially lush, filled with green. Doesn't it feel like the kind of grounds a school should have? More like a park with a clean walkway, going past trees and the smell of fresh cut grass and all other park-like things. Words like clean and hygienic pop into my mind. I shake them off. Say open-minded now. It's your new life. You have to take it as it comes. And that's what I tell myself. A few big buildings loom behind the leafy cantaloupes. Too big and too many for just a school. Everything seems off. It's different from what I thought I knew about school. It's uncannily valley. Even though I was told this was my new school, in the back of my mind it doesn't feel like one. I wonder if the feeling is real or caused by my expectations of a school for the disabled. Speaking of that, I don't see anyone here. It's kind of eerie. It makes me wish there was someone here so I could anchor myself to something tangible instead of having this feeling that I stepped into another dimension. Trees hum with the wind and the green hues flashing all around me catch my attention. It makes me think about hospitals again, how they say that operating rooms are painted green because green is a calming colour. So why am I feeling so anxious despite all this greenery? Only after I stand in front of the haunty main building, I surprise myself by realizing why the gates bothered me. It was the last chance I had to turn back. Even if I had no life, I could return to. But still, after entering, there's absolutely no way I could go back anymore. Feeling nervous, and with this realization set in my head, I open the front door. Man with bad posture notices me as I enter. We're the only people in the lobby, so it's only logical. You must be me. Nikki. Nakai. So you are. Excellent. I'm your homeroom and science teacher. My name is Matku. Welcome. We exchange a handshake that's neither firm nor sloppy. He looks at his watch. The head nurse asked for a brief check-in visit, but there's no time for that now. Oh, should I go later? Yes, afternoon is probably fine. We should get along and introduce you to the rest of the class. They're waiting already. Waiting for me? I don't really like being the centre of attention, but I guess it's inevitable in this situation. However, not knowing what is waiting for me makes me feel nervous. Thinking of this, I almost missed what the teacher is saying. Do you want to introduce yourself to class? I mean, isn't that normal? Of course, but not everyone likes to be centre of attention. I'm probably one of those people, but I guess I should be the one to give the first impression of myself. Right. But it's no problem. Let's go then. My heart is pounding in my chest, and it keeps me thinking about my condition as I follow the teacher up the stairs. The third door down the third floor corridor is marked as the classroom for class 33. Matku opens the door and enters. Good morning, everyone! Sorry I'm late again. I hesitate for a split second at the door, freezing on the spot. Get a grip! This is a big step, I know that, but there isn't any point of worrying so much about it. At least not this soon. I follow the teacher into the classroom and look around, partially so I won't have to meet the curious glares of my new classmates. It's pretty spacious. The ceiling is unusually high and there's a lot of space left over around and in between the desks. An entire wall taken up by blackboards and high old-fashioned windows only make it seem larger. The student desks are just standard wooden desks with a shelf underneath for books and wooden chairs with metal frames. Simple and efficient. I stop walking in front of the classroom and face the other students. They all look normal, like students from any other school, but then why should they be here? They're probably like me and have something wrong with them, only it's not something immediately obvious. Then I notice that one of the girls seems to be missing the thumb of her right finger. It's a little jarring. Despite the natural tendency to listen to when someone's talking about you, I tune out the teacher's speech halfway through while he introduces me to the class. I notice a flash of dark hair and see someone is looking at me. A girl with really long, straight hair that's pretty eye-catching. As she sees me looking back at her, she covers her face with her hands as if to make it invisible. There is one boy with a cane leaning against the lockers at the rear of the class. It's weird seeing someone so young with a cane. Another girl seems to be making some weird hand motions. Sign language. She peers at me over the rims of her glasses, then goes back to whatever she was doing. She's kind of cute. So is the cheery-looking girl with the pink hair sitting next to her. She's really hard to miss. I don't know how I even noticed her I didn't notice her the moment I walked in. Please welcome our newest classmate. Claps his hands. And so does everyone else, except one girl in the first row who has only one hand. I cringe a little, but hide it by bowing in thanks for this applause I did not deserve. A collective silence tells me that I should open my mouth now. So, I'm Yusuke Naki. And after that, my hobbies are reading and soccer. I hope to get along well with everyone, even though I am a new student. And after that, I'm being so boring. This is exactly like every self-introduction ever. I should say something more exciting. I end up saying nothing, and the teacher picks up from there. Everyone seems satisfied even with what little I said, though a few girls are whispering to each other, throwing glances at me. Could have gone worse. I listen to the teacher as he drones about getting along while letting my gaze sweep across the classroom Everyone seems to be listening to him intently, and when he's done, they clap their hands again, which seems like a weird thing to do. The first row girl claps on this round with her one hand against the other wrist that ends in a bandage stump. It makes me feel a little bad. We're going to be doing some group work today, so that gives you a chance to talk with everyone. Is that okay with you? Yeah, it's fine with me. That's good. You can work with Hamikachi. She is the class representative. She can explain anything you want to know. And who else would be able to do that better, right? How could I know? The teacher passes out the day's assignments and announces that we will be working in groups of three. It hits me that I don't know who Harakachi is. So, the teacher seems to catch my helpless expression. Oh right, Harakachi is right here. Shisuhu. Terrible at names. Shikuri Harakachi. As she calls out her name, the cute, bubbly looking girl with bright pink hair and gold eyes waves her hand at me. I take my seat next to her by the window.